found my daughter yet. What are you waiting for? Her army... Now, what do you need? Ask, then. Used to be my strongest supporters. Until we had an argument about how quickly democracy should be instituted in Colorado. When they lost that argument, they tried to usurp me, and... Well... Until they attacked the city, I thought I'd wiped out the whole family. Apparently, Neelius led some of them into the wilderness. I should have been more thorough. I assume it was Liberty who put them up to the raid. They were never this clever before. Fine. There are always complainers. What is it now? I don't let them do anything. I only pay them not to do it to Colorado. If arms are the only payment they accept, what am I supposed to do? Then they can band together like we did, become a state, save themselves. Nothing's stopping them. You expect me to care more this time than I did last time?
Neelius, I always planned to turn this nation over to the people when it was stronger. But Neelius refused to wait. He called for revolution, turned family against family, weakened us. I couldn't allow that.
The survival of Colorado is more important than one family.
Or one idea.
No, it's not. Not until you explain to me why Abigail Markham has left Steeltown, and you put it in the hands of some scrub. So you drove her away and left Steeltown in the hands of an amateur. Genius. If this rabble-rouser you put in Markham's place wrecks Steeltown, our infrastructure will collapse, Rangers. My people will starve. I didn't hire you to be mindless thugs, remember? I have those. One more misstep like this, and our deal is done. Understand? Get out of my sight.
What?
Why do you have ironclad cordite with...
Was it you who raided my prison?
What the hell is going on, Rangers?
Why are you asking them, coward? Are you afraid to speak to me face to face?
At least I'm a coward with a throne, not a dog who lost one. Now tell me how you're free.
Destiny.
Not a bad idea. Win or lose, that'll make a mess of her forces. Good call.
Lose? I will not lose.
But that doesn't excuse you breaking into my property and killing my employees. I've given you wide latitude, Rangers, but this is out of bounds. Another offense like this and we're done. Got it? Now what do you want?
One minute, Rangers. I wanted to thank you again for bringing energy from Cheyenne Mountain to Colorado Springs. It's a relief to have power again, now that we're not getting oil from the Gippers.
Now get going, and come back with results.
The
Good to see you, Rangers.
This is where they took me down. It took 20 of them.
Power to Colorado Springs! Receive warm welcome!
Maybe I'll throw in the horses. I do like to rub them pull up.
You can calm down a second.
Yeah. Always watching when I'm shopping and walking home.
You made it! Good! Come into the...
You're the Desert Rangers, right? The ones the Patriarch made a deal with. Good to see you. What the...
This fool works for...
Kill me?
Wait!
You side with this fool, and you make an enemy of me. Kill him here, and...
And I got...
Looks like you've got a decision to make.
Fucking idiots. Security, engage!
Okay. Now for what comes next. If you want to get to Liberty Buchanan, I have to be boss of the Scar Collectors. That means challenging Steel Trap to a duel. The first step is letting him know I'm here. Let's head to their camp. The most logical spot is north around the racetrack. And don't worry, the guards will let you in when they see you with me.
I don't like the guy either, but fuck. We can't kill the Patriarch's agents. What are we doing here?
Thank you.
should be mine, but still trapped dry gulch.
That does not look like a reputable establishment.
We're holy shit. Cordite.
Glad you remembered my name. Do you also remember how you helped Steel Trap drug me?
Hey, I didn't want to do that. He made me. He... Oh, fuck it. You'd never believe me anyway. Get him, boys! And watch his arm!
wretched vermin!
Thank you.
on our flanks!
Sickle of the USSR.
Pain.
tech mine. Sure, why not?
Привет, председателя.
That does not look like a replica.
There was a fight here.
What in the world are you doing? That's an innocent bystander you're aiming at. Rangers, if you shoot regular folk, I will no longer have anything to do with you. Is that clear?
Fuck off! Can't you see we're
glad you remembered my name.
Hey, I didn't want to do that. He get him, boys. Watch his arm.
Thank you. join who did so.
Friend in need.
Straight down.
Another day in here, I've been dead.
Thanks for saving us.
Blades are
door, not the master's. Too clean smelling. Who are you?
Oh, Master Cordite, is that you? It's me, Knock Knock. I was boss slave at the company store when you were here. But I lost my eyes, and now I make blades for the masters.
You were there the night Steel Trap drugged me and sold me off.
I was. Saw it all. That's why I lost my eyes. Steel Trap said I should stop seeing things.
Don't worry. I will avenge you.
Hope you'll take Steel Trap down a peg. Damn shame to be a slave to a man like that.
not supposed to steal traps as I'm only supposed to.
All right. Just keep an eye out while you're looking.
They call me Stitches. I'm what passes for a doctor around here. You need some stitching? If you're in one of the gangs, it's free. That's what being a slave is all about. Duh, because they'll kill me if I don't. You got a head wound or something? Sure. Come back if you're bleeding.
against these motherfuckers! I'll strike them down! I can see everything now!
I am the killer!
I'll find you! I'll get you!
Blades are
your, not the master's.
You were the. Don't
whoop. Hope you'll take Steeltrap down a peg. Steeltrap says I'm only. All right. Just keep an eye out while you're looking.
Thank you. Don't worry about guards.
Fine.
Cordite? With the Desert Rangers? Oh, now, damn it! This ain't fair!
What are you blubbering about now, Dorsey?
I swore vengeance upon these Rangers! They killed my brother! But if they're with you...
The Rangers and I have an agreement. Until it's concluded, they're under my protection. Afterwards, do what you want. Now open the gate.
Fine. I just hope you get to concluding sooner rather than later. I'll be waiting, Rangers.
Back at last.
How do you pretend idiota in such a business?
This must be where she is.
Be moving, trash.
Take a walk. Liberty only talks to leaders, not followers.
If Liberty had any honor, she'd come out and face us.
Alive. Steel traps gone. Look.
Time for some soup.
I says to let you go. Is that you, Cordite? Surprised you ain't ashamed to show your face around here after what you done.
I fell for the old man's bullshit. I admit that, and you had the right to call me on it. But not by selling me into slavery. You should have called me out, demanded a trial by demolition. Just like I'm calling you out now.
You wanna go? I'm gassed up and ready. Let's get it on.
You see, Scar Collectors, this is what happens when you let a coward lead you. Our tradition says we give a man time to prepare his ride before a duel, but that would make it a fair fight. And cowards don't want that, do they?
All right. I'll give you your time, asshole. But tradition also says no one hangs with us without a test. No exceptions. So if you and your shiny new friends want in, somebody's gotta play our little game. Right on. We Scar Collectors are about two things. Taking slaves and rebuilding ourselves better and stronger. If you want to hang with us, you gotta either prove you got what it takes to be a slaver, or you're committed enough to mod your bod. Behind me to my left is the punishment cage, where bad slaves go to die, eventually. Now to my right is the suture self-insta-surgery kiosk. To pass the test, one of you've got to either kill the slave in the cage or step into the kiosk and see what happens. What's it going?
Hell of a choice. Glad it's not me making it.
All right, then. Do it. What about that? Looks like your friend's got some guts, Cordy. All right, Cordy. You can hang here until you're ready. But if I find out you're fixing anything except your car, the demolition is off and the massacre is on. Deal?
Deal.
Good. Come back when you're ready.
Rangers, let's talk. Outside.
What have you done to yourself?
Who's the man? I can't hear you!
Fight Steeltrap in the Murder Dome. Biggest problem will be that Steeltrap won't fight fair. He'll have the Piassos and the Godfishers attack me from the outside, like the cheater he is. So we've either got to turn him to our side, or get rid of him. Lecherito is the sort of clown who'd tell you he was on your side. Then screw you in the end for a joke. The only way he'd switch sides for real is if he thought Steeltrap disrespected him or was laughing at him behind his back. I know for a fact that Steeltrap thinks Lecherito is a sniveling little wannabe. The whole camp knows it. What we gotta do is prove it to Lecherito. I wouldn't want him if I could have him. Too crazy. If their gods tell them to follow a jackrabbit through a minefield, they'll up and follow it, even in the middle of a battle. I'd rather find a way to make them leave the camp without a fight. Can't afford the casualties right now. We should go to the slave camp. Slaves always know what's really going on, and they have no loyalty. Lean on them, and they'll tell us everything. You lead, I'll follow. For now.
Yeah.
Dude, you don't even know. Their leader, Star That Dreams, decides if he's gonna sacrifice somebody by talking to the clouds. And his followers believe every word that comes out of his mouth. If he told them that everybody else's heads were full of candy, they'd start digging our eyes out looking for gumdrops.
There sure is. Kill Star the Dreams.
No, that wouldn't work. I mean, they might leave, but they go berserk first and cut all our throats. The best way would be to get his number one wife to tell him it was time to go. A Haloed Moon, her name is. Star of the Dreams thinks she's an oracle or something. He believes her sky readings like his followers believe him about everything else. Except lately, Liberty Buchanan's been whispering in his other ear, telling him about the sacrificial victims waiting for him in Colorado Springs, so he hasn't been listening to Haloed Moon as much. Still, if anyone could convince him to ride off into the sunset, it would be her. She's a true believer. Thinks the sun shines out of Star that Dream's ass. Loves him too, like a wife, like a mother. Cleans up after him, keeps away all the fortune hunters and fake mystics who follow him around. Only one she hasn't stopped is Liberty. STD likes power, and Liberty's got plenty. He's put Haloed Moon on the back burner, waiting for Liberty to hand him half of Colorado for kite meat.
Punk-ass pretty boy.
True enough. Got all the women in the camp just jumping out of their pants. But he's more than that. He thinks he's destined to lure the Godfisher gods down to Earth and bring about some big thunderstorm apocalypse thingy. Whatever it is, when it happens, he's gonna end up on top. And all the rest of us are gonna be food for the gods. But wait a minute. You're not actually gonna talk to her, right? I mean, I thought we were just bullshitting.
She hangs around on a little platform in the Godfisher's garage. Says she's meditating. Complete weirdo.
God damn it, you asshole. If the Godfishers leave, they'll take me with them. I don't want that.
You said you wanted to quit them, right? So if they go, stay.
Yeah, I guess. Yeah. Just don't do it.
What do you want now? We never do. We're not allowed to.
Leave me alone.